Welcome back to Development Book Club. Today we will conclude Facing Love Addiction. We'll get to the more positive stuff, which is part three, a healthy relationship. First thing we'll cover, chapter 12, are the marks of a healthy relationship. There are 9 characteristics, and this could be like relationship between spouses, parents, adult child, mentors, friends. First thing is that we view the other person realistically. We show up, we pay attention, we tell the truth, we ask for what we need and want, as do they. We let go of attachments to the outcome and share each other's reality. Number 2, each partner takes responsibility for personal growth. Working on the symptoms of codependence for yourself, we identify our own needs and wants here. Number 3, each partner takes responsibility for staying in an adult ego state. So this is like being an adult, regulating your emotions. Number 4, each partner can focus on solutions to problems. Agree on a plan to move forward and each person does what they have agreed to do. Number 5, each partner can be intimate with and support their partner a reasonable amount of the time. They don't sacrifice their own self-care and they don't do the work for the other person. So each person is responsible for their own self-care and doing their own work. Number 6, each partner has developed a life of abundance. Abundance comes from valuing and empowering your own self. 7, each partner can negotiate and accept compromise. This is the idea that with an abundance form, compromise doesn't feel like something is being ripped away. Number 8, each person is usually able to enjoy their partner despite the differences between them. And each partner or person can communicate simply and directly. They keep things brief, again, with that 4 sentences rule, which is great. And chapter 13 is about unrealistic expectations, and it's actually written by Pia's husband, Pat, which I thought was kind of a fitting end to a book. A relationship doesn't need to include all positive attributes all the time, of course. Instead of like trusting the process, take some risks in the process, and if you don't get hurt, you might just trust it. Trust is not a decision, but the result of previous certain actions. A little bit of a list of some unrealistic expectations. So at some point, I will find the perfect partner versus stepping back and looking at where we were last year or last month and seeing if we've grown. If a relationship ends, it was a failure. That idea versus the process of learning. And if it's not in both parties' mutual interests, leaving the relationship. Number 3, think about people should solve problems by discussing them rationally and reasonably. Good deal. Number 4, we have no conflict over maintaining mutually desired codes of behavior and characteristics of the relationship, that versus we look at things like availability, having fun, unconditional love, giving versus receiving, and sexual fidelity with different expectations and our definitions. Number 5, intimacy will be natural and easy versus it will be difficult. We may lapse into childhood fears. Intimacy requires healthy boundaries, self-esteem from within each person on both sides. Being in touch with who we are and knowing when it's appropriate to reveal who we are and when it isn't. 6, all our needs will be met all the time versus being healthy and fluctuating naturally on the emotion spectrum. The idea here, many recovering addicts believe that because they've felt so much negative emotion, recovery will be so much positive emotion, which is not the case. Unrealistic expectation number 7 is that problems mean that I need to end the relationship versus dealing opportunistically with problems. Abraham Maslow said, a satisfied need is not a motivator. Just this idea that we tend to only focus on what's not going right. And Pat mentions here to look at your needs that are being met. Finally, we can talk about evaluating relationship. Look at the problems. Right after telling us, she mentions this right after telling us to count our blessings, but to look at the problems, determine our tolerance level, are our needs being met or addressed? Physical violence, she says, what he says, just leave. Emotional, it's a judgment call. What's going right? And at the very end of the book, it says, Pat concludes by saying that along with self-acceptance, we need to develop and maintain realistic expectations for recovery in relationships and the acceptance of things we cannot change. These, I believe, constitute the cornerstone on which healthy relationships can be built. Thank you for watching.